Having balanced background music is important for your video viewing experience. I'll show you how to take your background music from being too loud and competing with your voice to just right and balanced for free. Hello everyone, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too. When it comes to background music in your videos, you want to make sure that your voice isn't competing with the music. Music is incredibly important for the videos you're making. Music can help set a tone, help keep a viewer's interest, or help the story you're trying to tell. Background music can also be stopped for effect. Like this, for example. If you're enjoying these filmmaking tips, consider subscribing and ringing that bell notification so you can create better content. However, a lot of the time, people's vocals are competing with their background music. But with Adobe Rush, you can balance your vocals and background music, meaning that with Adobe Rush, your vocals and your background music blend together perfectly to be more understandable for your viewer. Adobe Rush is free to install, and you can make edits either on your PC or Android/iOS mobile device if supported. You can download Adobe Rush for free via my affiliate link in the description down below. However, before you start any audio editing, make sure you're using a good pair of studio headphones. You'll also need to find the right background music. I use a combination of sites for my music. However, for simplicity, I'll be using YouTube's free audio library for the music used in this video. I've found a song I'd like to use, and I'll place it into Rush now. I think this music will help keep me focused and help the video be a bit more interesting. Let me know using the poll on screen, do you use music in your YouTube videos? Anyway, let's jump into Adobe Rush. If I simply just drag and drop my audio into Rush, and then play it with this new recorded clip, here's what it would sound like. Here's the clip at full volume just dragged into Adobe Rush. As you can hear, the music is too loud. You could just lower the song by clicking the audio section on the right-hand side. Or, if you're on a mobile device, you can select it by tapping on the track. Then, all you have to do is under Audio Basics, lower the clip volume. I think I'll lower this from 50 to about 25. And notice, while we're doing this, you can watch the audio waveform in the track getting affected. Now, let's hear an example. Here's the background music playing at full volume, and now being adjusted to 25% volume. Let me know in the comments below, can you hear the difference? This is much better than the audio from before. You can also see how visually different the clip was when we first put it onto the timeline compared to after we did some editing. Notice that the audio waveforms themselves are smaller. You can adjust the gain like that in most video editors, but it may not have the effect you want. That's where Adobe's advanced audio editing comes into play. You can get to the advanced audio sections by clicking on audio types and selecting music to show Adobe Rush's amazing auto-ducking technology. However, before we do that, let's reset the background music to what it was before we did the basic volume audio correction. First, click the audio you want to edit, or if you're on a mobile device, tap it. Then, under Advanced, it will identify the audio as music. The next thing you can do is select Auto Volume, and notice how on the channel section, it changes the audio waveform. Auto Volume automatically adjusts the volume so that the volume of your edited audio, or in our case, the music, matches the audio of the video. Basically, Adobe Rush helps balance the overall audio for you, which, if you don't know how to balance the overall audio, starting here is good. Once you get comfortable with what Adobe Rush is doing, over time, you can start experimenting and changing things to your liking, like you and I will now. You can also just hover over auto volume to see what it says. I'll show you what I mean with auto ducking. Auto duck automatically turns down the background music. Adobe Rush recommends to do this when there are other noises, or in our case, voices present. Once you apply the auto ducking, you can then select how much auto ducking you want done by moving this slider here, or here on mobile devices. Again, fine-tuning the background music until it sounds right for you. Keep practicing with the different audio levels until you get something that sounds good to you across multiple devices. The clip you're hearing now is my final version of both my vocals and background music. Check out that video on screen to learn how to make your voice sound better in Adobe Rush. Subscribe for more videos that'll help you make better content. And as always, I'm Andrew Can, and if I can, you can too.